Welcome back to my channel, guys. In this video we are going to see React Native Razorpay payment gateway integration. So one of my subscribed user requested me to make a video on Razorpay payment gateway. That's why I'm doing this. So what do we need to integrate Razorpay payment gateway? First we have to install this package. It's provided by the Razorpay official websites, and you need a Razorpay account where your money will be transferred, and you need a Razorpay account, and you have two mode here. One is test mode, one is live mode. Test mode for development purpose and live mode is for production purpose. And you, when you are trying to open your Razorpay account, I guess it will provide by your client, and then you have to, and if you are opening on your own, then you have to fill up your some details like payment information, like account information, your bank account information and your business information. That will Razorpay will need that to activate your account. So first we have to, and I am also created a empty React Native project with React Native CLI. So now I am going to install, and I will also provide the link in the description for this package. Now we have to install Razorpay payment gateway in our project. So npm install --save React Native Razorpay. So let's check out the documentation. So what we have to do is, first we have to import Razorpay checkout from React Native Razorpay. Then we just have to add a option or option object on your payment gateway description and your logo and currency and key. And here you have to provide your API key. As you can see, it's live mode and test mode. You will have a unique API key for test mode and live mode. Once you switch to live mode, then your test API key will not work, and once you switch to live mode to test mode, and your live API key will not work. Every time you switch between test and live, your API key will regenerate automatically. So every time it will be unique, and there is a amount you have to enter, amount for, obviously you are integrating a payment gateway, so you need to deduct amount from the user. And you have to enter your amount here, and if your currency is INR, then it's 5000. If you change your currency to USD or Euro, then amount will be according to that. And here is name, and this is prefill. When you are going to check out with, just let me check if the package is installed. No, it's not yet installed. Once you going to checkout page in your repayment gateway page, there will be an option you have to, where you have to enter your email ID, your contact number to continue. So this is the field, prefill. If you already have your user email ID or contact number or name, so you can pass that by default. If it doesn't have that information, that user have to enter that by himself or herself. Then it's the theme gets an object, and you can provide color according to your project color or something you want. So that is it. You don't have to do anything else. So my Razorpay payment gateway is still installing. And one thing you have to be remember, that when you are receiving a payment, like you add a project payment gateway in your project, so when the amount will be deducted in your Razorpay account and add to your Razorpay account, and it will be transferred by yourself, you have to transfer it manually from your bank account, or if you can set up automatically, it will be transferred to your account after 5 to 4 days. But that one thing you have to do is, you have to go to home, I guess. You have to go to home, then just let me check. When you come to your configuration, I guess it's open from settings. Yes, it's from settings. So here you can see you can provide theme color or logo and English language, default language. So here is the thing that when yes, this is the point. Payment capture. When user make a payment, so it will deduct it from the user account and it will add it to your RazorPay payment gateway in your dashboard. But the problem is if you don't set up your payment capture option. So when you are trying to configure, you will see a two option: automatic capture, manual capture. So if you don't set up your option to automatic capture, suppose you set up your payment capture option to manual, so if a user make a payment, so then you have to capture that payment manually by yourself in that RazorPay dashboard. And if you don't, then after 3 days or 5 days it will be refunded to the user automatically. And if you set to automatic capture, then it will automatically capture your payment after 2 days or 3 days, or maybe it generally takes 2 or 3 hours, but maximum it will take 2 or 3 days to capture that payment. And if you set to manual, so it will be refunded to the user automatically after 3 days or 5 days if you didn't capture that amount. So keep that in mind. So here you have to just set up that in automatic capture. My plugin is installed. Now I am going to run npm run android. This is the most important thing in this RazorPay payment gateway integration. So otherwise your money will be refunded to the user automatically after 3 or 5 days. And here is the API key. So if you want to go to live mode, then you have to provide a website URL, that your current project website URL or just app URL of the Play Store, then you will able to go to live mode. And if you are in test mode, then you don't have to provide anything. So I am switching to test mode. Then it's saying that it's created at June 24th, 2001, and here is my key ID. You can see that there is an option called test. When you provide a test API key, it will be see like test, and it will be see like live. So when you are trying to install RazorPay payment gateway after you run your project, you can see this kind of error that minimum SDK version 16 cannot be smaller than 19 declared in library. So what you have to do, you have to go to your project and go to your Android folder, then build.gradle. Here you have to enable minimum SDK version is 19. And save, then run. So while it's running, just you can do the code. So we don't need all of this. We just need a button to make a payment. and we need a onPress method. Now we're going to copy the code from RazorPay gateway. So this is our code. We have to provide a API key. So I will go to my RazorPay dashboard. Here is my test API key. Paste and save. And just let me center the button. This button is now center. It's center. So if I click on this button, cannot find variable RazorPay. Sorry, I forget to import. If I click on make payment now, it will redirect me to RazorPay payment gateway. As you can see, it goes like this. But one thing, if you are getting any error after upgrading your minimum SDK 16 to 19, then please synchronize your project with Android Studio and add this line in build.gradle file, Android folder, then app folder, then build.gradle file. In default config, add this line, multi-dex enabled, true. Then synchronize your project and clear your gradle, clean your gradle, then you are good to go. So now, as I can see, it's asking for 50 and it's showing the image and the name, as you can see here, and this amount is, as you can see, it's asking for 50 over here and we entered 5000. So if you have to multiply that by 100 to suppose you want to get, and you want the user to payment, and if I cancel we are getting that error log. Suppose I want the user to pay 1 rupees to me, and then I have to enter 100, then it will show me ₹1. As you can see, ₹1. So now you can see it's our credential. The description, it shows here. This is the description and this is the name. So if I change the name, and also I'm going to change the image. I have an image URL over here. So if I click cancel, if I now go to make payment, as you can see the image. So the image we give here, I never find a perfect high dimension in the documentation, but what I faced that 80 or 85 by 85 dimension will work fine, but after that you will didn't like you will show a image not found icon if you paste above that dimension, like you are going to use 100 by 100 or 500 by 500 dimension, that you will not get that image over here. So try to make the logo around 80 by 80 or 85, maximum 85, and you can change your theme color, like, and you have to enter your theme color, and if you want to change your theme color, and you have to enter 6-digit color code. 3-digit color code will show you invalid, so you have to enter 6-digit color code. So if I save right now, it will show me the black color gateway option. As you can see, it show me black color gateway option right now, and we are passing prefill over here, so that's why it's showing this number and email ID. And if you don't provide that, let me show you, if you don't provide that, you have to enter it by yourself. So if I comment it out, then I am going to make a payment, and then it will ask you for phone number, email ID. I hope you get this. So now if I make, so I'm going to save this. So you are using a test API key, so we can make payment. So now we can see our console over here. So now if I'm choosing net banking, it doesn't matter what you choose because it's test mode. So I'm choosing SBI, then pay. So in, if you are using a test mode, then you will see this page, the success or failure. And if you are using a live mode, then you won't see this page. So I'm click on success. So it will redirect me back to our page, and it will show you the payment ID. It doesn't return much, but you will have to do whatever you want to do with this payment ID. And it doesn't return much of data. So you will get the payment ID, and then you will do whatever you want to do according to your project flow. So, and this payment ID is as you can see, this is the payment ID. So now this is our payment ID, and if you change your currency, you can change the image, you can change the description. And if you change your API key to live mode, then you have to provide your API key, live API key, otherwise it wouldn't work. So there's a success method. And if you are getting, I'm going to tell you once again, if you are getting an error after upgrading this to 19, then please enable multi-dex in default config, and synchronize your project with Android Studio, and clean your Gradle, then run your project. So there is nothing much. So that's it. I hope you all like this video, and please suggest me any video you want to see in future. And if you want to, and if you like this video, you can buy me a coffee, link in the description. So thank you for watching. Subscribe to my channel to see more video. Thank you.